The Cyrus cylinder remains one of the most significant objects of the ancient world. A copy of it is at the United Nations as a sign of freedom. When it was on display in Tehran in 2010-2011, more than 1 million people came to see it. Clearly, it is a mesmerizing object. What then is the significance of the Cyrus cylinder in the modern world? King Cyrus was the founder of the Persian Empire. He ascended the throne in 559 BCE and immediately set out to conquer his neighboring kingdoms. In 539 BCE, 20 years later, he marched against Babylon and defeated the Babylonian Empire. Next, he allowed the subject nations whom the Babylonians had exiled to return home. In fact, he provided them with the very means to return and to rebuild their shrines and livelihoods. In 539 or 538, we don't know for certain, he wrote his famous cylinder that tells the story of Cyrus conquering the city of Babylon. Now let's turn to the cylinder itself. The cylinder is made out of clay. The inscription is imprinted onto the surface of the cylinder. This was done while the clay was still wet. The cylinder was then put out in the sun to bake, to make it hard and durable. The inscription is written in Akkadian, an ancient East Semitic cuneiform script. This, it is important to point out, was not the language of King Cyrus, who was Persian. It was the language of the Babylonians. Cyrus thus writes in the language of the people whom he defeated. Cyrus was able to bring religious freedom to his subject nations. He was able to send his subject nations home only because he ruled with absolute power. He was, after all, as he tells us on the Cyrus cylinder, the king of the four quarters of the world. This is not a declaration of human rights. This is smart imperial policy. For him, the Elamites, the Hittites, the Akkadians, and the Babylonians all built significant empires well before the Persians. But it would not have occurred to any of their monarchs to promulgate any form of tolerance, political or religious. In this regard, Cyrus was different. Clearly, he wanted to be what King Nabonidus of Babylon, the very king whom he defeated, was not, the king who brought freedom and allowed people to express themselves in their own religion. And I think herein lies the true significance of the Cyrus cylinder. We too should try to emulate Cyrus. We too should try to bring religious freedom.